keep my hands to myself. No matter how hard I'm trying to, I want you all to myself. Your metaphorical gin and juice. So come on, give me a taste.
Hey everyone, so today I'm gonna show you how face like the difference between a pleasure makeup look and then an equitation or a horsemanship kind of look, or even showmanship. So they're both gonna start off the same, like do your natural eyebrow, whatever you do, and then the same foundation and everything, that's fine. I do my concealer, my foundation, and my brows, obviously. And then you're gonna prime your eyes. So I'm gonna use the Urban Decay Primer Potion. This is the original one. And I'm just gonna put that on my lids. And then I'm just gonna set that with the Brulee eyeshadow from Wet n Wild. So this is gonna be my horsemanship slash equitation side. So for this side, I'm gonna take the Gwen Stefani Urban Decay palette. So first I'm taking Anaheim, which is a neutral kind of cool tone taupe shade, on a Morphe M504. I'm putting this all in my crease. And then I'm going to take a little bit of Zone, which is going to be a warmer brown shade, and do the same thing. Did anybody else watch Jaclyn Hill's holiday look? Because she's so on point when she's saying you go in, you go back and forth, and then you go in circles. And that'll blend it out, because that's totally what I do, and I didn't realize it until she said it. Anyways, if you haven't, you should definitely go watch it. I love her. Now I'm taking a MAC 217 in the color Punk, which is like a brown burgundy type color, and I'm going to put this into the crease very lightly. And then I'm just blending out the edges really quickly. Like I said in my last video, I like to kind of round out my look, so I bring the shadow up towards my brow where the arch is. And then I'm going to blend that out. And to do this, I'm going to take a little bit of Anaheim. And now I'm just going to pick up a mixture of Anaheim and Punk, just a little bit of Punk. And put this all over the lid. So basically with all of your horsemanship type of looks, you're gonna wanna do more neutral colors, nothing like you don't wanna do crazy hot pink or something on the lid. You just wanna keep it in the kind of earth tone colors. And you can still do smoky eyes, which is what I'm doing right now, but nothing too dramatic. Now I'm just taking the color Skimp. I'm gonna run that along my brow. By the way, this is a Morphe M433. It's basically the dupe for the MAC 217. Now going back in with the MAC 217 and picking up just Anaheim this time, and I'm gonna pack it all over the lid just to make it a little bit more neutral. And then bring it up into the crease a little bit and back to your big fluffy blending brush and blend. And moving down to the lower lash line, I'm gonna take a pencil brush and some of Anaheim. I'm just gonna smoke out my lower lash line. Again, we just want it to be kind of earthy tones, neutral, nothing too crazy. Then I'm gonna pick up some of Punk. And now I'm just taking this ColourPop shadow in Crimper. And I'm gonna take this on my finger and put it on my inner corner, just for a pop of a little something. Now I'm just gonna add some liner. I'm using the Tarte Tartist eyeliner. It's like the cream kind that you squeeze out and then paint on. You know what I'm talking about. Make me want you. Now I'm just taking a black eyeliner. This is the L'Oreal Silk Kissing Me Liner and Tight Lining. And now I'm just going to take a light colored eyeliner. This is the Chella Ivory Lace Highlighter. I'm going to do my waterline. And now I'm going to apply some mascara. This is the MAC Extended Play as usual. Just a thin coat because I am going in with lashes. And for lashes, I'm just using the Demi Wispies by Ardell. Okay, so for the lashes, basically you just want something that's going to be a little bit wispier. I mean, it's not like the judge is going to see your eyelashes, but I like to go for something a little bit wispier, not like crazy dramatic. Okay, so for this eye, I'm going to go in with Anaheim. And this is going to be the side that we're doing like a pleasure look on. And I'm going to go with some like really bright teals and blues. So I'm using my M433 and just putting this into the crease. Again, just like a neutral cool tone shade is fine. Then going back in with the M504, picking up a little bit of Anaheim just so I can kind of fluff it all over the upper crease. My camera literally hates me today. Tried a new setting and I don't think I'm gonna use it again because it just can't focus. I guess I'm kind of doing a slight cut crease, I suppose. So I'm sort of avoiding my lid with this shade and just deepening up the crease and always blending upwards. Really building up this color so it peeks through. And now I'm just going to take the Maybelline Color Tattoo in Emerald. It's a really nice teal kind of green color. On a flat synthetic brush, I'm putting this on the lid. So basically the pleasure look can be a lot more like fun, colorful, match your outfit, that kind of a thing. And I'm just keeping this on the lid. I'm not going into the crease at all. And then right on top of that, I'm going to go into this e.l.f. Giant Palette and take this color right here. Then I'm just going to grab this darker teal shade and I'm putting this on the Morphe M433 and putting this into the crease. Okay, totally did not expect it to be this pigmented. This is probably the first time I've ever used these eyeshadows. Again, I just build it up right where my arch is. And I'm just gonna dip back into Anaheim to help blend this out a little. And I think I wanna put a little bit of black. I think I'm gonna put a little bit of black on the outer corner. So I'm gonna go in with blackout now. And I'm just wiping off the M433. Taking a little bit more of Anaheim. And I'm just using whatever's left over on the brush to help blend these two together. Then I'm going into an Ulta glitter in the color Fairy Princess on that same synthetic brush and packing this on the lid where the teal is. And I'll go ahead and put some on my finger and bring it into the inner corner. Moving on to the lower lash line, I'm going to take Anaheim again on a pencil brush. And then I'm going to take a little bit of the black and just put that on the outer, I want to say half. Then I'm gonna blend this out a little. By the way, this is the brush from the Naked Smoky palette. So now I'm just gonna line my eye with the same eyeliner from Tarte, trying to keep this wing a little bit smaller. So now I'm just taking a little bit of the NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in Milk, and I'm gonna try to line my wing. So right there, and then I wanna bring it on the inner one as well. Now I'm just gonna grab my NYX eyeliner in 930 Teal. It has a little sticker so I couldn't see it. I'm gonna try to line my waterline. It's not very pigmented, but I am gonna put it in there just for a pop. And I'm gonna underline this inner part of the white. And I'll put some on the outer corner as well, just because I'm feeling artsy. Like so. And now that I have all that on, I'm gonna go back with some black eyeshadow on a pencil brush. And I'm gonna go ahead and darken this lower lash line. Now I'm just gonna tight line with the Silk Kissimmee eyeliner. And go in with my mascara. Once again, just a light layer. That's the wrong eye. Okay, I'll be back after I put these on because I'm trying to find the right one because, long story, I'll be back. Okay, so now I look thoroughly crazy, but I just put on, I was gonna use the Vixen lashes by Socialize. They're like, you've seen them a million times, but I couldn't find the right eye, and so I did the Glamorous lashes. So they're just wispy ones too, but I want the teal to peek through, so that's okay. Anyways, now I'm just gonna go into my face. So I'm gonna use the Shade and Light by Kat Von D. In reality, you can do the face the same way because they're both Rayo classes. The only time I would do my like contour and stuff different is for Showmanship because it's up close, so it doesn't need to be as dramatic. I'll probably do it about the same on both sides. So I'm just taking this cooler shade over here on an Icing Expert contour brush. It's double-ended. I'm just using the more narrow side. And like I said, on the rail, your face is gonna get lost, and so it's good to have a really fierce contour. Then I just like to go in with the fluffy side and help blend it out. Then go back in and chisel some more. So that's about how I'm gonna leave it. Do this side. And then here's my trick for contouring my nose. I can't get over how crazy I look right now. Okay, so I just kind of took a really, really, really little bit on my brush. And then I only contour the bottom of my nose because something like my nose is crooked or something. So if I contour all the way up, it just makes it worse. So I just go right on like the big part of my nose, the bulb of it, I don't know. And then I bring it down this part a little bit. See, like on this side I went up too high. So maybe it's just me. I don't know, some days I have good contoured nose days and sometimes I just don't. Today's just not a good one. And now I'm just gonna take the two banana shades. Not two banana, the two lighter shades. And just go under my eyes. I'm thinking that the Pro Fusion contour palette that I've been reading about is actually a dupe for this, but I'm gonna have to actually put it to the test like side by side and get back to you guys on this. But I just like when I'm in a palette to stay in a palette because it's easier. So I'm just doing this on where I put this concealer, so the center of my face, under my eyes, the usuals. This is, so the contour and highlight is going to bring definition back to our face, which is what we need when we're on the rail. Because like I said, you kind of lose all of that definition when you're so far away. If you guys go back and watch my very first video on YouTube, it's really rough, but I have some good points in there. I say it's kind of like dancers. You don't realize that they're wearing a ton of makeup because the lights, when the lights are on them, it makes it look totally normal. But if you see them in person, like after their routine, they have a ton of makeup on. So that's kind of how horse shows are, if you're like into makeup at least. When you're on the rail, you're gonna need all of that makeup to give you definition. Now I'm just taking the Too Faced Milk Chocolate. I really love this bronzer, and I'm using a Morphe M527. Really love this bronzer, but I'm like not quite pale enough to pull it off. I really have to build it up. That's the gist of it. So I'm just taking Champagne Pop on an Anastasia A23 brush. I'm putting that on the tops of my cheekbones again. I love looking glowy. My skin is so dry. And so that's really nice, like when you're on the rail, if the judge gets a glimpse of your highlight, you are gonna win that class, girl. And to bring all that craziness together, I'm gonna take the Urban Decay blush in Video. And just run this kind of in between my highlight and my bronze or contour. Now, moving on to lips. This is going to be the other major key. So basically, in horsemanship and equitation, like the classic thing to do is a red lip. I personally do it. I know like some people don't like it, but I like it because it's just like classic. So the one I use that literally lasts me forever in a day is the Kat Von D Liquid Lipsticks. This is the color Outlaw. So this is going to be really hard, but I'm going to do like half and half. So first I'm going to line my lips with the NYX Lip Liner in Deep Red. Wow, that looks really interesting. I'm just gonna do my lips all at once, but for the pleasure side, that's when you can really change up your lips. I mean, granted, you can do it for the horsemanship and stuff, but like I said, the red is kind of a classic like staple in the show world, at least. The pleasure side is where you're gonna be able to do like deep plums, which again, I guess you could do that for equitation, or nudes, or pinks, or anything you want, really. I'm gonna do a nude just because of what I have going on here. If I had more of like a subtle eye or like this eye, I could get away with like a deep plum lip. That would be really pretty, but I'm gonna go with a nude lip. So as always, I'm taking another lip liner in the color Natural because I just like that one. Okay, so now I'm taking Outlaw from Kat Von D, and mostly because I'm too lazy to go get a different nude color, I'm gonna take Lolita by Kat Von D as well. Again, it's gonna last you forever and a day or two. And the last step is gonna be to grab your Urban Decay Chill Setting Spray and mist your face so it lasts all day. So these are the completed looks. I hope this kind of gave you guys an idea of the differences between an equitation or horsemanship class versus a pleasure class makeup look. Basically, for pleasure, you can do whatever you want. You can do whatever color, you can do like crazy bold, you can do nothing. And then in equitation or horsemanship, you want to keep it a little bit more neutral, a little bit more like conservative, let's say, and kind of like tone it down. Yeah. So if you guys enjoyed this video, please give it a big thumbs up and leave some comments down below. I would love to hear from you guys because this was a really fun one for me. And I don't know if you guys can tell, but I'm sick. Bye guys, see you in my next video.